expression for electrical conductivity of a metallic conductor. When a potential difference is applied across a metallic conductor, an electric field E is set up inside the conductor. The electrons drift with a speed Vd in a direction opposite to electric field, and the drift results in an electric current I directed along the electric field. So let us consider a conductor. Let us say area of cross section of the conductor is A. So a potential difference V is applied across this. So due to this, there is electric field E set up in the conductor. So due to the presence of electric field, electrons move with drift velocity Vd in the direction opposite to electric field. So because of this, let us say a steady current I is set up in the conductor. Now our intention is to calculate the expression for electrical conductivity of the conductor. Now, if I consider the length of the conductor, we have taken it as L. So, volume of conductor is equal to area of cross section A into length L. So this gives you volume of the conductor. Now if N is number density of electrons, number density of free electrons, then number of free electrons in the conductor, if I call it as N, N will be equal to N A L. Number density means number per unit volume. So number of free electrons in the conductor is number density into volume. So these many free electrons are there inside the conductor. Now total negative charge, electron is negatively charged in the conductor, in the volume of the conductor, if I call it as q is equal to N into E, number of charges into charge on each charge carrier. So that should be equal to N E A into L. So this is total charge enclosed inside the conductor. Now let us say delta T is time taken for free electrons to move from one end to another. Right? If delta T is time taken for free electrons to move from one end to another, then electric current through the conductor I is equal to Q divided by delta T. So Q is what? N E A L divided by delta T. Now L divided by delta T is what? Time taken for electrons to move from one end to another end due to the presence of electric field. This is nothing but drift velocity Vd. Therefore what you get is I is equal to, substituting this Vd in this equation, we get I is equal to N E A Vd. This is expression for electric current through the metallic conductor in terms of number density of electrons, drift velocity, area of cross section and electronic charge. Now our intention is to get the relation for electrical conductivity. So what we'll do is, we know that I is equal to NEA VD, we have got this. Now we know that current density is I by A, so divide through by A on both sides, what we get is I by A is equal to NE VD. Now I by A is current density J, that is equal to NE into VD is, we had derived the expression for VD, drift velocity, that is EE tau divided by M. So you can write J is equal to N E square tau divided by M into E. So I'll write E separately. Now from Ohm's law in vector form, we know that J is equal to sigma into E. So now comparing these two, we can conclude that sigma is equal to N E square tau divided by M. So this is expression for electrical conductivity of a metallic conductor. So if this is electrical conductivity, we know that resistivity rho is 1 by sigma. So that will be equal to M divided by N E square tau. So electrical conductivity of a metallic conductor depends on number density of free electrons, relaxation time. E and M are universal constants. So it depends on number density of free electrons and also relaxation time.